Welcome to Market This Week. This is Ramesh Sigamani from Ravisa Templetree. In this video, we talk about where the markets are headed from here and the tightness in money flow that the people are having in their minds. As we step into the last month of 2018, there is a feel that the year went past very soon. It is said that if we are happy, time flies faster. Was it that 2018 was very happy and joyful? I don't think so. It had its own share of pains the whole year. Maybe the intensity of this pain that we had in our mind was so big that what happened in actuals was not to that extent, and probably that is the reason we have been experiencing that the year went very fast for us. November month saw the markets go up 7% after a steep fall that we had in the month of October. Will it continue? Is the pain of seeing our portfolios going down over? We will see to that. Crude oil and currency, which was a big threat to not only India, to the global markets just a month back, have taken a deep dive. It was actually not expected that both these crude oil and currency will take such a big hit. Similarly, even for our markets, it was not expected that it will go up so far from its bottom. Ideally, it should retest the bottoms, that is on Nifty, we should reach 10,000 again, and from there, if markets start going up, that will be a healthy upswing. As of now, on this expectation, markets should go down. So what is going to happen that will create this scenario? The US Fed slowing down on its interest rates is actually a good sign for the market, because foreign portfolio investors will bring in more money, while we are now stepping into a new uncertainty. In a day from now, we will have the five state assemblies which had gone for election, their results coming out. The exit polls that have come already is giving mixed signals, and probably the ruling central government will have challenges in these states because of anti-incumbency and many other factors playing in the markets today. So this will actually trigger the market to go down, and it has to hit the bottom. If without doing that, if it is going up, then chances are the upside will be limited. The GDP print that came last week at 7.1% was against the 8.2% which we recorded in the last quarter, was actually not a surprise to our markets, because 8.2 was not expected to be occurring often. And even at 7%, our economy will double in the next 10 years. So there was no worry. The other day, I heard Ramesh Damani, a noted famous investor in our market, saying that India is a 135 billion population country where without doing nothing, our economy will grow more than 6%. If we have a good government, it will have 10%. Else, it will stay at 7%. So now we are at 7%, not to worry. While the World Bank and the IMF are expecting a growth rate of around 10% for our country, with that numbers, we should see our economy reach 2.5 times from where we are now. That is $6 trillion economy for India by 2027-28. And the stock markets generally is 90% of the economic GDP. If economic GDP is $6 trillion, stock market should be $5.4 trillion. So where are we now? We are at $1.9 trillion, which means you just put money into SENSEX and in 10 years it will grow 150%. People were asking, how come this big numbers that all these analysts have been talking will happen in our country? This GDP expectation is one of the proof that our country will become a big economic power in the world. Coming to the next question, that the money flow in the country is very poor now, businesses are not happening, money is very, very tight. Even I agree to that, because even in stock markets, we don't see buying power, even in quality stocks. So to do a little more study on this, I went on to see actually what is happening. We have been tracking around 750 companies in our economy. Of the 750 companies, 221 have registered about 25% sales growth in the last quarter, that is September quarter, which is somewhere around 30% of the total sample what I am talking about. And out of the 750 companies, 256 companies have registered more than 25% profit growth, that is more than 33%. So growth is actually there, while it is in selected pockets. Probably this pain is because people in the unorganized sector are not able to do business today. And we are also having regular crisis coming up every other day on the lending side, where banks will now only lend to quality borrowers. This can be one of the reasons why there is a tightness in the economy on the money side. Because when we go deep into this, we actually, government also had a issue on the MSME liquidity with the RBI, where there was a tussle, and afterwards RBI agreed to bring in some liquidity. Even after that, bankers will not be lending to bad borrowers, because it's like once bitten, twice shy. They will not want to be answerable or questionable after they give out loans. So they will ensure they are safe. So let's look at it like this. Wouldn't it be good that our money goes to people where it actually works, earns, and brings us a better standard of living, rather than giving it to promoters who are not going to make it grow and end up paying taxpayers' money to clear the defaults? We should think around this. So these challenges that we are having on the cash flow side is probably the right thing which we are having, because economy such big and a democratic one will have to go through some pains if we are going to have a big changeover happening in our economy. In the meantime, as there is money flow tightness and all these things, are there businesses we can invest? Yes, there are. There are businesses like Bajaj Finance, Havells, Pidilite, like companies which have been growing consistently. We can see even when the markets have fallen, these stocks did not fall. And one more thought, as we are going to the general elections, and this election result has been due in the next 1 or 2 days from now, everyone in our country, whomever we speak to, want Modi government to come back to power, while have a fear that people will not elect this government again for the second term. I have a slight thought here. If everyone wants something, why will that not happen? So let us all believe that we will get the best of government who makes very good decisions and make India the world's biggest superpower in the next decade. Please like, share, and subscribe to stay updated with the channel. Also, would you have any comments on this video or on some thoughts you have, or thoughts or doubts about the stocks or the markets? Please put your comments in the comment section. We will be answering them either in comments or in our next videos. Thank you.